Good morning, students.
So in the previous class we had started with respiration in plants. We had seen the need of respiration, we had seen the cellular respiration and its equation, what are the reactants of respiration, what are the products of respiration. We had also seen the characteristic features of respiration. We have seen the phosphorylation versus dephosphorylation. We had seen ATP. We had seen about respiration's definition. Today we have to start with metabolic activities. So metabolic activities are what? These are the chemical reactions which occurs inside a cell. The chemical reactions which occur inside a cell is known as metabolic activities. These metabolic activities are of two categories, that is catabolism and anabolism. Okay. So catabolism is destructive, anabolism is constructive. The basic difference, the catabolism is a destructive process and the anabolism is a constructive process. In catabolism, the energy is released, and in anabolism, the energy is consumed. The catabolism is a breaking down process and the anabolism is a biosynthetic process. So now can you add basic simple definition is what? In catabolism, a large molecule is broken down into smaller ones, and in anabolism, small molecules joins together to form large molecules. So in catabolism, the energy is released, whereas in anabolism, the energy is absorbed. Okay. So these three differences you must have understood. Catabolism is a destructive process. Anabolism is a constructive process. In catabolism, energy is released. In anabolism, the energy is absorbed. Then in catabolism is a destructive process. Anabolism is a constructive process. Now, can you tell me one example of the catabolic reaction in which large molecule is broken down into small molecules? Very simple, that is respiration. Can you tell me one example of anabolic reaction? That is photosynthesis. Okay, in which carbon dioxide combines with water molecule to form glucose and oxygen. Now we have to see the comparison between the respiration and burning. So what is respiration? Respiration is a series of chemical steps. P is missing over there. Sorry for that. Whereas burning is a single step process. You have seen in the previous class, respiration is completed into two basic steps. We have seen that glycolysis and Krebs cycle is there. Glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm and the Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondria. Okay. So glycolysis is itself a multi-step process, and Krebs cycle is also a multi-step process, but burning is a single step process. Now the question arises, why glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm or why Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondria? The reason behind it is the enzymes essential for glycolysis is present in the cytoplasm and the enzymes essential for Krebs cycle is present in the mitochondria. So each step of respiration requires a specific enzyme to get completed. Okay. So that is why respiration will require enzymes, whereas burning will require heat. Then respiration is a biochemical process, whereas burning is a physicochemical process. So let's understand, what is biochemical process? It's a chemical process and it occurs inside a living cell. So that is why it is a biochemical process. Physicochemical process because it occurs in the outer environment. And chemical process, any organic compound, when it is burnt, it forms carbon dioxide, it forms water vapor, it releases energy. So that is why it is a chemical reaction. It occurs inside the, in the outer world. So that is why physicochemical process. The energy released in respiration is the biochemical energy and some amount of heat energy. Whereas the energy released in burning is the light and heat energy. Okay, respiration is a cellular process and burning is a non-cellular process. Respiration occurs at body temperature and burning occurs at high temperature. Then the plants respire through the whole body. So what are the parts of the plants which helps in respiration? Here, in spite of respiration, we can say it in the exchange of respiratory gases. So plants respire through leaves, stems and roots. So what is the location of stomata? Stomata is found on the epidermal surface of the leaf. And what is the purpose of stomata? It helps in the exchange of respiratory gases. And it remains open during the day, but it closes at night. Whereas the lenticels are minute pore-like structure which is present on the stems or tubers. And the purpose of it is to help in the exchange of respiratory gases, even at night. So stomata closes at night. And then root, the general surface of the root is also helping in the process of exchange of respiratory gases. Clear? So plants take oxygen and leave carbon dioxide, but it is different. In plants, during the daytime it takes carbon dioxide and it releases oxygen, and at night it takes oxygen and it releases carbon dioxide. The reason behind it we are going to discuss. So you have to notice over here that stomata, location of stomata is what? Present on the epidermal surface of the leaf. Function of stomata is, in context of respiration, it helps in the exchange of respiratory gases during the day condition. It closes at night and it also helps in the process of transpiration that you will study in standard 10. Then lenticels are minute pore-like structure present on the stems and tubers, and the purpose of lenticels to help in the exchange of gases at night. Then roots, general surface of the roots, that also helps in the exchange of gases. Here is one point you have to notice, that plants get dry in waterlogged area, or if a flood is there and after that the flood gets over, the plants also over there gets dry. The reason behind it, if there is water logging, the soil pores of the water will be filled, soil pores will be filled with water. There will be no oxygen, there will be no such air in the soil pores. So the general surface of the root will not be able to respire. And when the general surface of the root will not be able to respire, the plant will get dry. We have also seen that before sowing of any seed, the farmers, they do the tilling or ploughing of the field. The purpose of tilling or ploughing is what? It helps in the aeration of the soil. So between the soil particles, spaces are left in which the air will be filled, and the roots of the general root surface of the growing plant will be able to respire properly and the plant will grow properly. Okay, so these two reasoning based questions will get arising over here, from here, that plants get dry in waterlogged area and plants also tilling and ploughing of the field is done before sowing of any type of seeds. Then one should not sleep under a tree during night conditions. The reason is, during the day condition, the rate of photosynthesis is high and the rate of respiration remains same both during the day as well as night. And if you will observe the equation of photosynthesis and respiration, the product of photosynthesis is the requirement of respiration and the requirement of respiration is the product of photosynthesis. So both are complementary to each other in case of plants. It is not applicable in case of animals. So that is why we don't release out oxygen. This is the basic reason. So during the day condition, when the rate of photosynthesis is high, the production of oxygen is high. Okay. So whatever oxygen will be required for the plants to do the respiration, that much of oxygen is kept and the extra amount of oxygen is released out. Okay. So, as well as when the rate of photosynthesis is high and the rate of respiration remains same both during the day and night, so whatever carbon dioxide is released in respiration, by the plant cells will be consumed for photosynthesis. But as the rate of photosynthesis is high, so that is why plants will take up the extra amount of carbon dioxide from the air. So that is why the plants take carbon dioxide and releases oxygen during the day. So it is very good to sleep under a tree during night, during the hot midday. But it is harmful when a person is sleeping under a tree during the night condition. Reason is, respiration is same both during the day and night. Okay, so but the rate of photosynthesis declines at during the night condition. So when the rate of photosynthesis decreases, what will happen? The production of oxygen will get less, but the rate of respiration is still same. So that is why to fulfill the requirement of oxygen for the continued process of respiration, the plants will take oxygen from the surrounding and it is releasing the same amount of carbon dioxide. But here now the rate of photosynthesis has declined, so whatever carbon dioxide can be utilized, that much is utilized, and the extra amount of carbon dioxide is released. So during the night conditions, the plant will release carbon dioxide as well as it will consume oxygen from the surrounding air, and the person who is sleeping under the tree may get suffocated and die. Okay, so there are many misconceptions and beliefs behind it, and this is the biological reason why a person should not sleep under the tree and why a person should sleep under a tree during the day condition and why not during the night condition. So this is all for today. You will write down the notes as well as you will do the progress check in your book itself. Thank you.